why this Sonbhadr is in news nowadays?
So there have been incidents of killings due to land dispute by the local leaders. So there have been incidents of killings because of land dispute, and it has been committed by the incitement by the local leaders.
Okay. How many people have been killed in that? Get some detail.
Sir, four people.
Four people have been killed, and this has become that much big drama, political drama.
Four people are 11.
Oh, I think I'm confusing with the Muzaffarnagar case. 10 people have been killed there, and these were the tribal people.
I think it was 14.
Okay, I'm sorry, sir.
Guess करने का आपको आदत है थोड़ा सा. Anyway, और कुछ बताइए उसके बारे में. Why Sonbhadr is considered unique district in UP? कुछ unique district है. ऐसा क्यों है?
Sir, I have no idea about it.
No idea.
I know about the incidents
that one of the biggest district also. Chaliye, what is the present data you have about employment in UP? Since the new government aayi hai, how many new jobs have been created? Kuch idea?
No, sir.
Anything done by the UP government for empowering more women in the state?
Sir, government is, has initiated a new program for strengthening women security, like especially in Lucknow there was Operation Majnu. There was an operation regarding arresting the people whoever are indulging in such activities in public places.
But employment ke liye, has government done something or not? For women, we call it a women economy. Mm-hmm. Because these are the, you know, almost 50% in our country. And all over the world, you know, the women are equally partner as far as jobs are concerned. They give a proper, almost parallel economy. In India, it's almost zero economy.
So government is just implementing the schemes regarding the proper, they are doing proper implementation of the schemes which have been provided by the central government, especially for the skill development and strengthening of the SHG sector, special help, self-help groups.
No, but there are several such small scale industries where women can do their work only at home. There are so many schemes, so many industries, so but government has to give some encouragement to the women and some develop some awareness, provide some infrastructure. So is such type of thing is there or not?
So what are your they are strengthening the rural banking infrastructure so that the finances could be provided by the mudra loans to the rural people and women at large. And this is the
no basic idea about some such programs.
Yeah, I don't have any idea about specific program by the UP government.
You have done is missing BA or?
So BA, BA.
You have done BA. Sociology. Tell us something. Old age scheme for senior citizen in the UP state.
So government is implementing the Indira Gandhi National Old Age Pension Scheme, and recently the government has also increased the amount in this regard by rupees 250.
Why the government is not you know giving unemployment allowance to the youth everywhere and almost in other country foreign countries? They are giving youth who are without job should get at least some amount for their sustenance. So why is not there in India or maybe in the states?
So the concept of the economic survey last year also pointed about it regarding the through the concept of universal basic income, but government is not having that much budget so that it could provide it, and the overpopulation is also an issue, and since India is having a large huge amount of huge number of population which is in the category of youth under National Youth Policy. So it's not feasible for them, and they're trying to skill them so that they could get self-employed.
Who was Ram Manohar Lohia and what is his contribution in our Indian political system?
Sir, he was a socialist leader, and he has contributed immensely in development of political systems and strengthening of democracy, in, especially in Uttar Pradesh. And he is also considered to be the founding fathers of the Samajwadi Party and some other parties in Uttar Pradesh.
Are you in some job presenting?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
In which department?
Yeah. Sir, I am working at the Lok Sabha Secretariat at the post of Assistant Executive Officer.
With Lok Sabha Secretariat, New Delhi?
Yes, sir, New Delhi. The grade pay of 4800.
Okay. Since how long?
Sir, since April 8, this 2019. This year.
So, your first choice is CISF.
Yes, sir.
You tell me why you have given the first choice, CISF. What are the benefits of this?
Sir, specifically, I don't consider any force as a different, and this was just from my peer review that some of my friends are in services. They asked me to give this preference, and I want to be in a uniform job.
Mm-hmm.
And my father is also some instructor in UP Police, so that is the motivation for me to enter the
Did
service.
Did you try for the UP Police job also?
Sir, I have. I'm giving this UP PCS. Means for the DSP.
Okay, UPPC is your name.
Yes, sir.
What are the job profile in CISF? What type of job you have to perform? If you become assistant commandant, what would be your duties?
Sir, especially we would be guarding the critical infrastructures and also providing the security to the VVIPs. And they are definitely a part of internal security.
Suppose you are assistant commandant and posted at IGI, Terminal 3.
Yes, sir.
And 100 people, constable, they are under, working under you, maybe 2-3 inspector. And all of a sudden, you know, there is a shooting at one corner of the, or at one counter of the IGI.
Yes, sir.
And you have observed that people are shooting. What would be your action?
First of all, I would deploy my force urgently there, and I would rush myself also. And if somebody
they are shooting, you know,
they're okay. Many people are shooting.
Many people are shooting.
Okay.
And you are alone.
If I am alone, so firstly, I would analyze the situation immediately and call up my subordinates, whatever force is available, through my walkie-talkie, whatever we are provided, so that we would contact. And I would at the same time also inform the local police regarding the incident, and whoever, whatever, if there is some incident that somebody has been injured, I would follow up, get them to the hospital. I will call the hospital people also, if possible, to send the ambulance and whatever necessary things are needed.
You know, if you compare the political system of India with US, which one is better? What would be your, you know, analysis based on comparison? US, the president is all in all. In India, prime minister is all in all. What are the other differences in the political system?
Actually, India is a parliamentary form of government. We are having a parliamentary form of government.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas in USA, we are having a presidential form of government, where the cabinet is also belongs to, cabinet comes from the bureaucrats or whatever the president thinks is correct. But here in India, we are having the legislators who form the government. And this is the major difference. And I think here accountability is more. And the government can fall any time if if most of the legislators lose their confidence, because the government is coming out of the womb of legislature here. But in USA, it's the case is totally different, where president, the executive and legislature is totally separate, and they have very little control over the executive there.
Last question: what are national disasters?
National disasters. National disasters are the specific definition I don't know. National disasters are disasters which have humongous impact on large area and population, and they are regularly updated by the government what they consider as national disaster, and further the government of India releases funds in that case also to assist the state governments, because they are basically in the domain of state government to deal with them.
Being elected a member of parliament in Lok Sabha?
Sir, person should be a citizen of India, and his age should be 25 or above, and he should not be having any insolvency cases pending against him. These are the three main criteria.
And what are the immunities that an MP enjoy?
Sir, whatever he speaks on the, whatever an honorable MP speaks on the floor of the house, whether it will go on record or not, that is decided by the house, and he is free from the arrest also in civil cases 40 days before and after the session, and basically the issue is that most of the privileges are not codified in India, which is a demand also, but it's yet to be coming up.
You are from UP?
Yes, sir.
Barabanki district?
Sir, Lucknow.
Lucknow district?
Sir.
Okay, then you tell me about Awadh region.
Sir, Awadh?
Whole Awadh region, not Lucknow.
Sir, the concept, this word Awadh region was initiated by the, during the rule of Mughal emperors, who were having their seat at Faizabad, which is currently known as Ayodhya, and later on this was shifted to Lucknow, which is the current region and the capital city of Uttar Pradesh.
Okay, can you tell me the history of Lucknow or specificity of Lucknow?
So the multicultural syncretism is the basic specificity which I experienced in Lucknow, and the Hindu-Muslim unity is one of the unique feature, Lucknow.
Okay, there is an art called chicken curry.
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Sir, it is a traditional embroidery art which is done in Lucknow. And how to define it? They use the white. That white thread and do embroidery on the clothes.
Okay, recently a place in UP that is called Chunar is in news. Can you tell me about Chunar?
So Chunar is known for limestone mining. And I know this question. I haven't, yeah, no idea about it.
Okay. Have you read the paper today?
Yes, sir, I was reading about that Karnataka
show. What is that?
Sir, the issue in Karnataka is that their coalition government was currently ruling, is ruling also right now under the Honorable CM Mr. Siddaramaiah, Mr. Kumar HD Swami. And now, because it is a game of numbers and it's about politics also.
Okay, can any governor of the state direct chairman of the house that you should have a floor test?
Yes, he is well within his powers because it's a discretionary power. And that is not defined, so we cannot say what is. And the matter is also in the Honorable Supreme Court. Yes.
Your subject is sports science.
So sociology.
What is the difference between Union Federation and Confederation?
Union
Federation and Confederation.
So I could explain it in context of India. Yeah, union is a federation is the constituent part of a union. Like in India, we have 29 states. They are part of a federation. It could be different in different countries also. Like if we take example of USA, that is a federation where different states came together, like 13 colonies, they came together and united to form a single union, that they will be ruled by a single common center. But in India, we are having a different kind of federation where states cannot secede themselves. They are part of the union, and union can decide how many states will be there. Yes, sir.
How can you define as a SC category according to the constitution?
So constitution mentioned about it in the article 341. Yes, sir. And there is also a provision
why
in 342.
Why we use a category scheduled?
Because it is mentioned in the schedule of the constitution.
Why? What is this schedule?
Constitution has been divided into certain schedules which are having different.
No, scheduled caste, scheduled tribes. What is meaning of schedule? Why we call this caste in schedule?
Sir, because by the order of president, it is mentioned in the constitution in a particular schedule.
Only meaning of schedule.
So I don't.
Why this is schedule and not schedule?
So no idea.
Why not? You are from Lucknow.
Yes, sir.
Tell something about 1857 revolt.
Sir, it is also considered. Sir, in Awadh, the leadership, the revolt occurred under the leadership of Begum Hazrat Mahal, and whose son Brijesh Qadar was. Yes, sir. Whose son Brijesh Qadar was denied the throne, and the Britishers also looted their property.
Interested in
Sairi? No, sir.
Lucknow is famous for
Sairi. Yes, sir, it is famous.
But many famous
Sairi.
You don't know?
No, sir.
What is Imam Bada?
Sir, Imam Bada is a. It's an architectural heritage in Lucknow which was built by Wajid Ali Shah. And it was built basically to reduce the impact of famine and provide employment. And it has many small chambered entrances.
Ma'am?
Yes, sir.
You know about Naxalism?
Yes, sir.
What do you think? This is a political problem or this is a socio-economic problem?
It is a socio-economic problem which has been exploited by the political, which has been exploited for the political mileage by the people and by some people, some outfits who are trying to gain power through it.
How
we
start? From where?
Naxalism basically it started under the leadership of Charu Majumdar and the yeah Kanu Sanyal, and the land alienation was the basic reason, and because of the poor implementation of the land reforms.
But you know, West Bengal and Kerala have a very good policy in land reforms.
Yes, sir.
So why in West Bengal?
West Bengal provided the leadership only, but it
leadership only. You say naturally start in West Bengal.
So it started in West Bengal, via the Telangana movement also. In 1946, from where the demand started.
What was Telangana movement?
So it was also a land right movement.
What was? This was a peasant movement.
Peasant movement and dominated by the women participants.
What was the main reason of Telangana movement?
Sir, alienation of the common masses from their socio-economic rights.
Socio-economic. But why not in Bihar, Uttar Pradesh and other Maharashtra, Punjab, Rajasthan, they also landlords.
So they have landlord. It could be about the leadership provided that time by the people there. And
what was Eka movement?
Eka movement, it was
in
also it was about the dispute between the zamindars and peasants, landlords, in 1921-22.
My last question.
Yes, sir.
You are assistant commandant, CRPF.
Yes, sir.
You are posting in Bastar region.
Yes, sir.
You are going for a movement. And
yes, sir.
Your battalion is on way. You are briefing. And one subordinate slept you, comment slept you. What will be your quick reaction?
First of all, because I am his commanding officer, I would.
He is a constable.
Yes, sir.
And he slept in front of your battalion.
Yes, sir, I would go for the disciplinary actions against him. And.
What will be your quick reaction?
I want,
you know, 1 or 2 minutes.
Sir, I would ask my subordinates to hold him.
He told he is angry with you.
Yes, sir.
He is angry with you. He wants to leave.
First of all,
But you cannot, because your throat is angry.
Yes, sir. First of all, I will ask my subordinates to stop him, and then I will talk to him, and I will tell him that it is the reason of a national whatever duty you are here, you have to do it.
Okay, man. Very kind.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Remove. Bye.
जॉब के लिए ज़्यादा से
फॉल्स ये नहीं है।